think the best compliment I ever received was from a graduate student who told me that she would not have been able to finish her thesis and her research in any other lab. She felt that we believed in her, even when she no longer believed in herself. Hi, I'm Tom Chau. I'm a professor in the Institute of Biomedical Engineering in the Faculty of Applied Science and Engineering at the University of Toronto. I'm also a senior scientist at Holland Bloorview Kids Rehabilitation Hospital. My work focuses on developing technologies to enable children with disabilities to communicate. So we are currently in the rapid prototyping hub at Holland Bloorview Kids Rehabilitation Hospital. This is a shared lab space where students and staff develop prototypes, do 3D printing, build circuits, build the fabric prototypes, and basically test out new ideas. We discover the unique abilities of each child and develop technologies to cater to those strengths. So for one child, their preferred means of communication might be using their brain waves. For another child, it might be humming or twitching a muscle or blinking their eyes. So whatever modality the child prefers, we develop technologies to allow them to communicate and to express themselves through those modalities. I think in hindsight, it probably was when I was very young, even as a grade schooler, I had a notorious reputation of always breaking toys. And I think it was actually, I was curious as to how things worked. So I would always disassemble things, but I could never put them back together. So my parents, to their dismay, I would be always breaking new toys because I'd be opening up the insides to see how things worked. So I think that was kind of my early calling to be an engineer. I think one big question that keeps me up at night is how technology can best support the development of children with disabilities, knowing that each child is so unique in their abilities. And I think a related question is how do we use technology to cultivate or promote adaptive changes in the child's brain? So how do we maximize the neuroplasticity of the child's brain in a way that encourages development of the brain so that the child can acquire skills that are going to be useful for them later on in life? So an attribute that I really admire in my students is resilience. I've had the privilege of journeying with many students over the years through many personal challenges, whether it may be health or financial difficulties, loss of a family member, whatever it may be, in addition to the having to do their research. And I've really been awestruck by how these students have been able to weather rough seas and high winds and remain positive and hopeful throughout the whole thing. Well, one of the activities that brings me a lot of joy is making things with my hands. And in particular, I enjoy making rosaries. So I make rosaries out of wood and also out of glass. So this is an example of a wooden rosary that I made. And I do all the carvings on the centerpieces as well. And I also make the crucifixes. Something else I really enjoy doing is playing flutes. I have a collection of flutes from all around the world. And so this is the one example of one. This is a Native American flute, and I have a collection of these in different keys. They have a really beautiful sound, kind of really ethereal, really peaceful. And sometimes I take these out into the forest and just play them, me and the insects. I think what I love most about the U of T engineering community is just the sheer excellence of the students and the faculty. Being in a community where there's so many learned people, so many outstanding scholars, really challenges me to be a better supervisor, a better researcher, a better mentor every day.